Confluence is the single most important factor when it comes to finding the best trades. And in this video, I show you step by step how you can use Confluence in your trading to improve your trades, your entries, and your trading strategy as a whole. So when we just talk about Confluence basically just means that you have specific rules and specific criteria that you layer on top of each other or stack on top of each other to create a more robust trading process. So what does this mean in real trading? It's pretty simple actually. And then there are a few things that you need to consider when it comes to using Confluence to improve your trading. So first of all, let's take a look at my example or one of my strategies. One of the most important Confluence factors is that I always look at the daily time frame, and on the daily time frame, I look for specific things. For example, on a pullback strategy, I look for the market in a trend, trading back into the moving average and then hitting the moving average. This can be one Confluence factor. Another Confluence factor could be then you look for a specific candlestick pattern on your daily time frame. It can be an engulfing bar, it can be a two-day pin bar, it can be a one-way pin bar, and there can be many other things. But those are two Confluence factors on your higher time frame. And once they are present, only then you will go to the lower time frames. And if they are not present, no matter how amazing the lower time frame looks like, you just have no business in trading this because you need to have those Confluence factors. I distinguish between mandatory and optional Confluence factors. And then once those are present, then I will drop to my lower time frame. And then I look for other specific things. For example, you could look for a price divergence in a trend. You look for a trend that has a specific length. It can be candles, it can be waves, it can be a specific moving average. For example, you want to see the market trading above a specific moving average, or another Confluence factor could be that you look for a cross in a moving average. Another Confluence factor could be that you don't take trades 20, 30, 50 minutes before a high impact news event. Another Confluence factor could be that you look only for trades that have a high enough potential reward. So for example, you don't want to take trades that immediately face a big support and resistance level, or where you're immediately trading into a big moving average. And then you can see how you can stack multiple Confluence factors on top of each other and then use them as a checklist. And I've talked about checklists and the importance of checklists so many times. And you can turn your Confluence factors into a checklist, obviously. So you write down all your Confluence, higher time frame trend, higher time frame candle, lower time frame news, lower time frame divergence, lower time frame whatever. And then you end up with maybe 6, 7, 8 points on your checklist, which are all individual Confluence factors. And then you just tick them off one by one by one, and you will immediately and objectively see, is this a trade? Yes or no? And if it's a yes, you take the trade. If it's a no, you have to stay outside. Don't let the voice in your mind talk you into the trade. Have a physical checklist that will help you even more, because then you see it in front of you that this is not a trade. And once you have done that, you will improve the consistency of your trading significantly. All of the traders, they always say, I want to have a trading strategy with consistently profitable results. But it always starts one step earlier when you have consistent actions. Only consistent actions will lead to consistent results. That's really, really important. And this is where many traders go wrong with Confluence. And one of the biggest problems that you can have in trading, or when it comes to Confluence, and that I see, is that you have your trading system, you have your rules, and then you take a trade and it ends as a loss. And then you look at the single event, at the single trade, and you ask yourself, how could I have avoided this trade? And what indicator, what rule should I add or take off in order to take this loss and turn it into a potential winning trade? And this is really bad because you immediately get into curve fitting and overfitting, which means that you are not making your decisions based on a sample size, which means that you don't look at your past history of your last 20, 30, 40 trades, and you look at what happened and what didn't happen, but you look at a single event and you let that single event influence your future trading performance or your future trading behavior. This is obviously real bad because this single trade that ended up as a loss, it could have been just a random outcome. Even the best trades will fail, and there doesn't have to be a reason. The only thing that you need to make sure is that you always follow your Confluence factors. And the only time you can actually change your trading system is once you get back to your trading journal and then you look at your last 20, 30, 40, 50 trades, and then you see and you analyze, what do the winners have in common? Then do more of that. What the losses have in common? Do less of that, or work on something to improve it. Maybe add one Confluence factor and one rule, and you can only add this one rule based on your analysis of a big enough sample size, because only then will the change have meaning going forward. It could be that the single loss was just a random event, something unexpected happened, and there was no way of you preventing that. And it may not even happen again in the future for the next 100 or 200 trades. So whatever you change now will have a negative impact in the future, because it's not based on sample size analysis, it's just a single random event. So this is how you can use Confluence step by step in your trading. And the first thing that you need to do now is you ask yourself, okay, what is the strategy that I trade? What are the different rules that I trade? And if you don't know that, look at your last 10 trades, look at your last 10 best trades, and then ask yourself, what do all of those trades have in common? And this is how you can come up with a first checklist with your first set of Confluence factors. Then over time, after you repeat, or after you use this checklist for 20 more trades, 30 more trades, then you go back to the drawing board and then you analyze, and then you can change Confluence factors. You can add new ones, you can take off ones, but never based on a single trading loss or a trading winner or whatever it may be.